Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon, and thank you for taking the time to look at this video and to see a little bit of information and some of the views of this trailer before you come in and look at it, and to get familiar with the salesperson that took it in on trade. And this one is one I took in on trade. The people that owned this lived in the Eugene area, and they took very good care of this unit. And when you come and look at it, you'll see that that is true. It is in excellent shape. It's got an electric tongue jack that they installed. It has the window in the front. Now this is the bedroom area right here on the inside, but they've got a little door right there for the window. It's got pass-through storage as well. And it has jacks on all four corners, manual crank down. It is a sheet metal sided trailer, and this unit weighs a little under 5,300 pounds. So it's well into that half ton towable range. Even some of your SUVs will have no problem towing this trailer. It also has a propane jack right here for an outside barbecue, or if you wanted to put one of those propane style heater standing lamps, you can right here in your camp area. Tires are in great shape. It's got chrome wheels. Also has a nice big awning that covers almost the full length of this trailer. This unit's built by Skyline, and Skyline has been in business since 1951. So it's probably one of the longest lasting manufacturers in the United States today. It has a nice bumper with a diamond plate wrapped around it with a spare tire and a carrier. Also has a ladder so you can access the roof. And the prior customer put a little receiver hitch on the back so you can put one of those bike racks on the back if you want to. As you come over to this side, you got the hot water heater. It's a 6 gallon. And then you've got cable TV hookups right here as well. There's for your furnace right here. It's ducted. It also has a wasp protector right there that keeps the wasps from building a nest up in that furnace area. Got a nice little slide out. This is going to be a sofa slide. And as we come over to this side over here, because it's a rear kitchen, you got two discharges. You got one for the kitchen area, one for the bathroom. So you got two gray tanks. You also have an outside utility shower. And exterior light right here. This is kind of nice because if you do get into your campsite late at night, you've got a little light here that you can help get connected up and everything. Sewer flush station right here as well. And of course, you've got your water fill cap right there. Let's go take a look at the inside of this trailer. Now, as you come into this trailer, you're going to come right by the refrigerator. It's a 6 cubic foot, two-door refrigerator, so you got refrigerator and freezer. Also has a battery shutoff connection right here, and this is your converter. It's a three-stage converter. Stainless steel appliances, so you got your stainless steel Atwood stove top and oven with a Dometic microwave. Comes with a fan and light over the stove top. Nice big kitchen area with lots of countertop space. You've got drawers and access in underneath the sink. You've got the high-rise spout sink faucet right there. And a dual sink. They call it a 60-40 sink. Also have a lot of lighting right here in the kitchen area. Here's your control for your hot water heater. And here's your water pump, and your galley info tells you about gray tank, black tank, fresh water, and your battery condition. It's got a ducted air conditioning unit in the ceiling with 4 speakers for your stereo system. This is your built-in CD player right here. Also has an AM/FM radio. Nice dinette area with lots of room here. This also turns into an auxiliary bed area if you need it. This TV right here isn't working. Does a great job, and it is outdated. It's a analog TV, so you do need to get a converter box to use it, but it does work. Also has a nice big sofa here as well that's built into the slide, and this also makes up into a bed. So that folds down and that becomes another sleeping arrangement for whoever it may be. This is where you put someone you don't want them to stay too long. So that's good for one or two nights. Also, if you come into the bedroom area, you've got nice closet space here in the hallway. I'll let you take a little shot of that storage in there as well. And as you close that door and you open up the bathroom door actually works to close off the bathroom bedroom area. If you, there it is, it's got a magnetic stick at the top right hand corner that holds that door closed. So that is your, it actually makes the bathroom and bedroom one room, if you want it to be. Got a sink in the bedroom. Nice feature about that, it takes the sink out of the bathroom, so you can have somebody utilizing the bathroom and somebody utilizing the sink. So you can actually have two different functions going on at the same time. Also have a vent here in the bedroom. You could put a fantastic fan up in there if you wanted to. Then you got closet storage on each side with drawers on each side. Little cubby on each one. This bed is a queen size bed. Lifts up. There's storage underneath it. Also, the bedroom has its own door, so you can go in and out through the bedroom if you want to. And it has another TV hookup in that far corner right there. This is a terrific unit. It's a 2006 Nomad 2500 rear kitchen. It's in excellent shape. I'd love to work with you. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. And you know, if you buy something from Joe Bass, I'll make sure you get a free gift. Thanks.